Bell Pierce serves a bullet down to five, and that one's going to be pushed over easily. Brittany Hobley. Oh, and that's what the Gigi's are going to have to look out for all day today. Brandy Wilkerson, she's going to work in her office from the left side, the right side.
She's just got such a fantastic vertical and so many shots.
Pierce fires that one down the line to five. A cross-court shot by Diddy Vaj, but dug well. Pushed back outside Wilkinson, sharp cross-court, but almost dug by the Gigi's as that ball goes off the roof. And really, a good start for Wilkinson from the right side.
Absolutely. It's working out very well between her and the setter right now. And she's changing up her shots.
And Pierce gets the gift as Tyler takes a ball that was sailing well out of bounds. Michelle Pierce doing a great job for the Lions, serving tough here in the first set as she serves that one. And again, back-to-back aces. Steph Tyler having difficulty passing this ball. And Michelle Pierce going right at her. Pierce sails that one long, but York really being aggressive on their serve.
Oh, yes. That was one of their keys to success in the last game. They just served so tough against the Gigi's, and that proved to be very difficult for us.
It did indeed. That'll bring Alex Derivage up to the line as she serves tough, just clearing the tape, but a good pass. Back outside to Black as she hits off of hands, but dug well by Miriam English. Pushed back outside, Kelty English high off of hands, but dug, and a great ball staying alive as Wilkinson keeps that one in play for York. Pushed well outside to Tolme, and that's high. Hit out of bounds, and a great play, good heads-up play by York.
Yeah, York is just such a scrappy team, and it's so much fun to watch when a team just doesn't fall. So the Gigi's have to be prepared for that and ready to fight back just as hard.
8-4 here in the first for the York Lions. Brandy Wilkinson serves a bullet that hits off the tape. Kept alive well by Tolme. And that one pushed back outside. A nice swing. Black getting reaching on that. Pushed back outside. Holly Morelli tips that, but dug by Wilkerson. Roll shot. Roll shot scores for York. They open up a 9-4 lead here. And the Gigi's are really going to want to get to their pass.
Yeah.
Wilkerson once again serves that and handled well by English. A dump right in the middle of the court, but fatal four hits.
Yeah.
Sharp call by Malcolm Mousseau there. Kelsey English now serving for the Gigi's. And that one caught one of the Gigi wind currents and just sailed out of bounds.
It did. At least I'll give her that it was an aggressive serve.
It was an aggressive serve. And that's what the Gigi's are going to need here to get back into this first set. Down 10-5. That'll bring Black to the line as she serves down 5-1. Tipped all the way around Sophie Chanel, able to just continue that one. Wilkerson high hit but hits the 6 and dug. Pushed all the way to English and blocked, but she digs her own hit. Another hit by Miriam English to the back row. And a fast hit, but a solid block in the middle. Sophie Chanel all over that ball.
She is just one of my favorite players to watch. She's so entertaining and just so happy to be on the court.
Totally intense and ready for every play. Sophie Chanel shuts down the York middle offense, bringing Colleen Morelli to the line. She serves the 6. Flemmer hit Wilkinson once again, cross court with that. And a nice push off the side of the hand. Miriam English just doing a great job of scoring tough.
That's an aggressive tip. We've seen a couple of plays here where the Gigi's have backed off a bit. I think that tends to happen when you're down by a few points. But Miriam, that's a very aggressive tip to go off hands there.
A great tip for sure. As we see Morelli serving for that one and dug by the Gigi's once again. Trying for the line shot. Miriam English just misses that one on the tape.
Totally the right idea and totally the right attitude. I love it, and I think if she keeps playing like this, it's gonna start picking up for
it her. It is. Brittany Hopley now for York. And she serves that one. And again, catches one of those upward currents. and just sails out the back. Sophie Chanel now will serve for the GGs. Still trailing 8-11. Chanel serves that one to 5. Pushed way well outside. Pierce able to get that going, but dug well by the GGs. Pushed back to English, and she tips. Dug well once again. Pushed outside. Game of tip right now by both teams. Set up. Step around. Wilkinson doing a great job. And that is a really effective play where Michelle Pierce is stepping around and Brandy Wilkinson comes in because the block is already gone.
Yeah, and that's really one of Brandy's strongest shots. She puts it right down the line and it's so tough to dig, but we've really got to be prepared for that one.
It is. Steph Tyler does a great job of handling that one, but a handling call. Kiara Tomei unable to get that one out of her hands clean. And that'll open up a lead for York, 13-8 here in the first set. Kristen Dillon now. She serves down towards 6. Oh, my goodness. And that one not called a lift. A great dig by the Gigi's to keep that one alive. And Wilkerson makes no mistake. She goes outside the block. And Coach Woods will want a timeout. York being dominant right now.
Absolutely. I think we're really going to need to talk over this block right now. She scored 3 times that same spot right down the line. And we really need to take that outside blocker and have them stay there.
Yeah, you see both blocks coming inside. It's a great observation, Kat. And really, there's so much offensive power on these York Lions. It's very, very difficult to stay inside because they can have a field day outside the block.
100%. And I think most diggers will agree it's much easier to dig a cross-court ball than it is to dig that hard ball down the line. So I'd really hope that the GGs are talking about this right now and they're able to change this coming up.
Well, it's tough when York's doing so well at passing as well because their offense is very potent. They have so many different options. And as you said, they like to run the middle and keep the middle involved as opposed to most teams that really run an outside offense. Kristen Dillon will serve here now again. She takes that one to 1, and Steph Tyler passes that one well, pushed well outside. English hits high, but dug well by Black. And that one's just being continued in by Dillon. Pushed out outside. And that one, a great inside shot in 3 zone. Miriam English unloading that right to 4.
You know, it's funny, right before that ball was set, I was just about to say, we need to start incorporating different zones of the net.
Yes.
And just like that, it's like they read my mind.
And they're doing it. Well, you're entrenched in this offense of the GG, so you understand what they're doing. And that's a tough pass. Dug well by Tyler there as it's pushed outside. And English gets the advantage of Pierce's hands and scores on a ball blocked out of bounds. And the GGs creep back 10-14 here in the first set. Kiara Tomei back serving for the GGs now. Tomei better serve this time. Handcuffs York. And that one pushed outside. Wilkinson high roll shot down to 6. Pushed outside to English once again. And a roll shot down as Black handles that easy. Pushed well outside. And a great high hit shot. Alex doing a great job there for York from the left side. And Michelle Pierce again. Heads up play in the middle. Does a great job. And that'll bring us to the technical timeout, 16-10 here in the first. To 10. the Gigi's really looking to make an adjustment. And like I said, the Gigi's, if there's anybody that can handle it, make an adjustment blocking, it's them. But boy, oh boy, there's a lot of offensive threat here by these York Lions. That one's pushed deep. Steph Tyler handles that one, pushed tight. And once again, ball passed a little bit too tight to run a fast offense. Another unforced error by the Gigi's. Alex Arshovich now back for York. And she sails that one just long. Alex just missing the line there for York. And that'll bring Miriam English up to the service line for the Gigi's. And she does a great job. She serves that one deep to six. And that one going to be put over. A miscommunication once again on the Gigi's side. Tough play.
It really is. I mean, we've got a new blocker in here with Callie. She's a first-year player, and so getting into the system is going to be difficult for her. There's going to be some miscommunication, and a few plays like this will happen. But, I mean, at 18-11 in the set, it's really time to get our stuff together.
It is. It is. And you're going to have to count on the veteran play right now of both the English sisters. And really, you know, you have a lot of rookie play on the floor right now. With regards to Sophie Chanel not playing that much last year, as well as, you know, you now have Callie Sorrow on the floor as well. So there's a lot of new play when it comes down to dealing with this York offense. I think when it comes down to it, you saw it for 5 years, and it's been potent every single year that you played them.
They always have their like a huge arsenal of weapons just coming at you, and you really got to respect this team.
Yes, you do. And that'll bring Michelle Pierce up as she sails that one long. So Michelle Pierce's error will bring the Gigi's back, stepping a little bit closer, 18-12. And Alex Delivage. Delivage will serve this one deep to five, and that one dropped out of the bottom. But great job by York to keep that alive and run an offense back out to English. And another good dig. Tough play, because very well executed off of a scramble play, but net call, or actually foot violation call by York, and that'll hand another point to the Gigi's. Still trailing 13-18. Alex Derivage. That one just sails long. A lot going on right now in this gym with regards to air currents, Kat.
It would definitely seem that way. A few too many service errors here.
Brandy Wilkerson now for York, and she sails that one well. And I'm noticing that these aren't missing by a foot. These are 10, 12 feet out of bounds.
Yeah, this is definitely one of the tougher gyms to serve in. There's just so much space and open air that
yes.
The ball really floats.
Kelsey English now, she'll serve and get that one in. Handled well by Black, and a nice fast offense as that's kept alive by the Gigi's. And a super block! What a block by Tomei outside, shutting down Black.
I mean, I've said it before and I'll say it again. I love when a setter gets a stuff block.
It is the best. English, she'll serve once again, and that one handled well by York. Push back. Wilkerson keeping that one alive. And Black will just put that one over free as English passes that. That's a step around. And Chanel keeps that one alive with the tip. That's a tight at the net. Ball's up. And another block by Tomei. Good scramble play by the Gigi's as they continue to close here in the first set. They narrow it down to three, and York calls the timeout.
You know, Gigi's have proven time and time again that they're not a team that you can count out. Even when you seem to be up by a lot, they just pull their way back in there.
Well, it's the composure and how they do it. They never look flustered. They don't look upset. They stay at it. And, I mean, this is a good team, which you can expect to be down in sets. You can expect them to come out with solid offense. But chipping away, like you say, is probably one of the most important keys for the Gigi's to stay on target, getting that pass, and also serving tough.
Yeah, I think one of the main differences I've seen, too, is in the first half of this set, York was getting all of these scramble plays, and Ottawa wasn't fighting back. Now we're kind of seeing a little bit of the reverse, where Ottawa is able to put some of these scramble plays back over the net, and that's just really helping with the score.
It is. And a level of confidence right now in serving as well, as Kelsey English pushes that one, and Wilkerson hits that one cross-court to one. Dug well by English, pushed back outside, and that one just missing out. Off the 4-5 line side. Callie Sorrow just missing that one. Octavia Wong is going to be in serving now, serving specialist for York. Wong serves that one right down six. And Tyler handles that one well, pushed outside. And a miss once again, second miss in a row by Sorrow.
She's trying different angles here, and she's being aggressive. It's such a tough position to come in and have to perform right away.
It is.
In the middle of a set.
And that just a rocket as Miriam English handles that one well. Kelsey English roll shots that to six, but dug well, pushed well outside, and what a great shot. Arsovic able to just go right over top of the block. And, I mean, that'll show you the depth right now of York, you know, without Melissa on the floor, still being able to dominate from the left side.
Yeah, and not any single player dominating by themselves, just so many different players.
Yes. And Sorrow's able to contact that one right in the corner as she opens up her scoring here today and will continue back on the service line. Callie Sorrow ready to serve now for the Gigi's, as Jennifer Black is back in the game. Sorrow just clears the tape. All the way back outside, and a better block there. Tomei keeping that one alive. English hitting high off of hands, no touch.
She was definitely going for hands there. It's too bad that that didn't work out.
Yeah.
As she planned.
Miriam English playing very high above the ball, just missing hands on that one. Handing York their 23rd point of this set. They lead 23-17 here in the first. And Callie Sorrow, that one drops in front of her as it pegs the corner. Beta dying for the first time here as she has a service ace. Beta now serves that one. Tyler handles that, and that's the next play. Just touched on the block, but kept alive. Well, English takes that one out to her sister and blocked well by Pierce as that one's dug up. And Chanel will push that one up for English. Wilkerson unable to dig that, and a great shot by Kelsey English.
Great high swing. Once again, she's proving herself over and over again throughout this set that she's a force to be reckoned with, and she's hitting high and strong. Super hard to defend against.
So we'll have Vero Kaye in for the first time here as she serves to defend for the first set. And that one's a good serve. Back outside to Pierce. She tips that one, but English punches that one over. And it's just going to be kept alive as a free ball as Kaye keeps that one alive. And that's no doubt about that one. Huge gap in the middle, and Miriam English puts an exclamation point on that.
Yeah, and I absolutely love Tomei going after that ball and pushing it all the way up the outside. It was a very fast pass, and she kept her head about it.
So Kaye will do it once again. A foot fault to lose the set. A tough way for the Gigi's to drop the first set here. But really, a good way to finish. Good, strong, aggressive play by Miriam English. But again, we see the domination of York in how aggressive they are. They served aggressive that first set. Excellent defense, and really did a good job of distributing the offense.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. They just seem very calm and put together right now. We're having a little bit of trouble, I think, communicating, it seems. Some new players on the court, and just passing in general, it's making it a little bit tough here. So hopefully we'll be able to calm down a bit, refocus, and restart this set.
York right now dominating their performance in the OUA and even in their preseason. They maintain a fourth seed in the country. And they'll be looking for ultimate revenge all the way down to the last whistle of the OUA championship, because I'm pretty sure that unless there's some major upset, they'll be fighting for a spot to go to CIs this year.
I would be very surprised if there was another outcome.
Yes. And as you know, with the GGs finishing top four last year in the national championship, that gives the OUA two berths this year, where that's probably one of the first times that Ontario's had a two berths in many, many years, probably 20 years. And that'll give the opportunity for the first place and second place teams to both compete in the national championship this year.
It's so nice, too, to have two different Ontario teams in at the CIS championship, just because the West doesn't get a chance to play us that often.
That's right.
And so it'll be two different styles of teams that they get to play and get to see that Ontario volleyball isn't lower than they are. It's a very different style of play, and they'll get the opportunity to play two very different strong teams.
That's right. And, you know, as each team competes here in the OUA, obviously we know how aggressive they'll want to play against each other. But there's also something said for the OUA performing within the CIS. They want to make sure that we finish top four every single year, regardless of what team it is, because we want to keep showing the nation that the OUA is somebody to contend with. And really, in the past, OUA has never gotten the respect that they actually need.
Couldn't agree more.
And I'll take this opportunity to say hello to my past partner as a co-host. I know Carrie's watching this afternoon. I hope you're having a great day out there, Carrie. Carrie downtown, just about to head to Ryerson. Home crowd's going to be loud for that one, he says. So, absolutely, best of luck, Carrie. I hope you guys do great. Carrie, of course, stepping out and being the head coach for the RMC Paladins this year. And you know, it's amazing, bringing up a good point here, seeing a text come through from Kerry. Being a medalist within the national championship as well may even create three berths for the OUA. So that would be a dream come true for the OUA.
Sure,
as Tomei opens this set and set up, that push well outside. And a much better job of starting the block outside and moving in.
Yep.
And Wilkerson gets shut down in the first point of this set.
Fantastic job of setting up that block. It was so easy to close. Very smart play.
Tomei will continue serving here for the Gigi's. She takes that down one. And an excellent movement on that ball as she has a service ace, opening up a 2-1, 2-0 lead.
Yeah, there's a serve we know of for us.
Yes. Tomei serves that one once again. Same spot, down one. Has a fast offense, but kept alive by Soro. Pushed outside. English, nice high hit, but dug well by the Gigi's. And Derivage puts that one up, but English is unable to get that by. Arsovich shuts that one down from the left side as she takes the ball. Alex heading back now to serve for York. English handling that one. Pushed well outside. English keeping that alive cross court as York digs that. Pushed back outside. And black is shut down by English. Great job by Miriam.
That block is just such a technical block. Pushing her hands back inside the court so that there's absolutely no chance it's going to ricochet off and go outside.
A technical block for sure, as Miriam English unfortunately doesn't have such a technical serve on that one. She wanted that one back, and you can see in her toss that she knew that was going to be trouble as it left her hands. Michelle Pierce now serving for York as she fires a bullet over, but Tyler handles that one well. Derivage, a great shot cross court and kept alive. Wilkerson's going to roll that one down one, but dug by the Gigi's, and a fast attempt by English. It's kept alive. A roll shot, but English digs that as Tomei's underneath, putting outside. Soro makes no mistake. Callie Sorrow shows her strength as a rookie here in the second set.
That's a great swing by Callie. Just one blocker up. She didn't have to worry too much about the hands, but she went after it strong, and it got us the point.
So a great rally there by the Gigi's as Alex de Rivage now takes that one. And she serves down six, handled well by Alex. Wilkerson shut down once again, and it seems like Sorrow's caught on fire.
Oh, absolutely. She's just coming out of her shell right now. And I really think that in, hopefully throughout the season, but even in years to come, she's just going to be such an emotional presence on the court.
Well,
you can see how fired up she is.
You can see it right now and how she's handled the last three plays. Denny Vash fires that one down. Alex handles that one once again. Pushed well outside, but a good close on the block to keep that alive. As a free ball is going to be coming now. Handled by English. Pushed well outside. Domain. And Sorrow just doesn't get that one over the tape. Bit of a scramble play between both Kelsey and Miriam.
They just have a bit of a
top over. Yep. Randy Wilkerson now will take the ball for York. As she jump floats that one down six. And Steph Tyler passes that one up all the way outside. And Kelsey English unable to get that by the block. That ball pushed a little bit far outside, Kat.
I think that's happened twice now. The one that Alex set up for her a little earlier, I think she wasn't expecting it to come quite so far out. She used her step around approach. It didn't quite work out for her.
She did. Wilkerson now serves that one once again. Steph Tyler handles that one well, pushed outside to Sorrow as she roll shots that one. And Kelsey English gets called for reaching over. Not quite sure if that ball was on the way over or not, but
maybe a little too aggressive.
A little too aggressive, yeah. For sure. Obviously, Malcolm Mosso has a much better advantage point than us. Mm-hmm. And that served once again by Wilkerson. Pushed outside and a nice tip, but push. And that ball going to hit out of bounds. A great push. That's changing up the offense,
yeah,
for Chanel.
Yeah, just very smart on her part, calm. It wasn't a fantastic set. The connection wasn't there, but she did something very smart with it.
She did, indeed. 6-5 lead for the Gigi's here in the second set as Kelsey English will take the ball for the Gigi's, and she bolts right off the tape, pushed outside quickly, and both the block and defense behind on that faster shoot. And that'll tie it up here at 6. Black takes the ball now. Passed up well by the Gigi's. Pushed outside. Sorrow dug once again by English. Pushed back outside. Sorrow once again off of hands. All the way up. Kelsey English able to pass that first contact. Miriam English from the back row. But a great dig, but unfortunately off the roof. Jennifer Black unable to control that. But what a powerful shot by Miriam English.
My favorite play. It's just my favorite. It's so fast. Nobody sees it coming, and she's just so powerful.
Powerful for sure. Kelly Sorrow now will take the ball for the Gigi's. She serves a rocket that we knew was going to drop. And this rookie right now is lighting it up for the Ottawa Gigi's. She's been responsible for half the Gigi points here in the second set.
She's doing such a fantastic job. She seems to just be bringing the group together on top of it.
Totally agree. Sorrow serves once again down to five, and that one handled much better by York. And Miriam English absolutely drops that one to the floor. Kat, that one was on the floor before the players landed.
It's so exciting to watch. I absolutely love it. Once again, just so technical. She's just putting on a blocking clinic right now.
It is. 9-6 to Gigi's lead here in the second. Callie Sorrow once again pushes that right outside. Arshavix handles that and pushed and tipped. But dug well by English. She pushes that outside and just misses. Unable to get all the way back outside.
It's too bad. I really thought she had that one in. I don't know if she was sure her head was out with that play, though.
Yeah.
Not a big deal.
No.
Get it back.
Gotta get it back. Exactly. Brittany Hopley now serving. She'll take that one right down six. Steph Tyler passes that one well. All the way out to English. And English, once again, devastates that block.
And we got to give props to Steph for the pass there. Beautiful pass, really easy set to the outside, and Miriam just being stuck to
you. You know, we talked about how important the pass was, and Steph Tyler nailed it there, able to run an offense so well, and Miriam English just capitalizes on it. And that one held well by Chanel. Pushed all the way outside, just blocked outside, but really right now we see the Gigi's block doing a good job of catching up to the fast York goal fence.
Yeah, you know, there was no surprise in that step around, and I think that was just mere inches.
Yes,
out, so.
Mere inches for sure. Kristen Dillon now, she'll serve that one as Kelsey English handles that. And just on her way down, Kiara Tomei unable to tip that one over. The advantage of the left-handed setter, unable to capitalize on that play. Kristen Dillon once again for York. And that one just sails out once again. Good call by Kelsey English. And that'll open up a two-point lead here for the Gigi's once again in the second. They trail 1-0 in sets. Kiara Tomei serves that one down to one and just passed, but a lift call. A lift call there on the York setter. Kristen Dillon unable to keep that one off on an overpass.
It's too bad. I really love when the setters are able to pull off a one-handed set. It's just so exciting.
It is. It's very, very aggressive. Tomei serves once again and difficulty handling that one as Steph Tyler pushes that one up. Again, Michelle Pierce, good heads-up play to keep that one alive.
That's gorgeous.
And that one. As both sides scrambling, but Coach Witt screaming four on that contact.
Yeah, I definitely thought that that block would be considered contact.
Yes.
In that scenario, but like you said, the ref has a much better vantage point than we do.
Yes,
so.
Exactly. So a 13-9 lead here in the second set for the Ottawa Gigi's. They still trail this match 1-0. But a great job, a good execution, and the Gigi's have really lit it up. Right now, I think if we were going to put an A+, it would be on their blocking.
Oh, I couldn't agree more. It's come together since the last set. Already, you just see such an improvement. And if they can continue rolling with that and just shutting down the York open, there's no question in my mind that they can take this game.
Exactly. And, you know, this is really at the point right now, and with all due respect to the current players that are on the floor on the left side, this is really where Melissa would take over. And she really shows her leadership as a player for York and would really dominate back and bring York back some big hits at some crucial times. So I know I can sort of see her on the bench right now as she's cringing, gripping the back of the chair. Tomei once again serves that one. And that one served one, dug well. And that kept alive off the tape. Pushed well outside. English is able to keep that one alive. And a great heads-up play by Miriam English as she gets blocked. But that ball tipped right down. Good heads-up play by Miriam English.
Yeah, really great play on her part. Athletic.
The Gigi's open up a five-point lead now as Tomei serves once again. And she serves a rocket down to one. Handled well by York. Wilkerson hits that one. A nice job. An excellent rook. An excellent play by the rookie, Sorrell.
I absolutely love that pot shot. She's come out swinging all game. So obviously York is going to be dug in on their defense. Put that nice little easy tip into the pot, and they're all left on their heels.
Tomei once again fires a rocket down six, and dug well by York. Put back outside to Wilkinson, but blocked by Dudivash. Pushed outside, and that one, no ability to get that one back in the court. As Arsovich hits that one wide, and then the Gigi's doing an exceptional job right now of being one step ahead in speed.
Yeah.
Against York.
And just like we talked about, they're getting that blocking system down, and it's really forcing York to make some desperate plays. Like we saw,
yes,
in that last one, she's really just trying to put it anywhere where the block isn't and losing control and putting it out.
The other thing that we've seen, Kat, is the Gigi's have now gotten back into their service rhythm. And really, that aggressive serve is just pushing a couple of those three passes to twos and ones where York does not have every option available right off a serve receive to go after. As we all know, they have so many options off of their serve receive that it's tough to deal with. So the serving has definitely aided the block, and the Gigi's really have done a great job of handling York. Up 16-9 right now, but as you've always said, and we all say, the set is a long way from over. We know how York can play, a very aggressive, spirited team. So as we have a break in the action here, we'll remind you that tomorrow afternoon, Ottawa will host Nipissing here at 2 p.m. at Montpetit Hall. I unfortunately will not be here. I will be on my way to Toronto, so I think Kat, you will be here, and Kat will run a solo job. She'll do a great job. Kiara Tomei serving once again. That one handled well by York. Pushed outside by Wilkerson. High shot, but Sorrow digs that one as Tomei pushes that out. And another great shot by Miriam English as she uses the advantage of a late block.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's really tough to come up against. That's four big, strong hands against her, and she's just hitting so high and so hard.
It is. Tomei, she serves that one once again. Deep. Not getting over the net there. Tough play. Arsovich unable to get that one over the net. And really, right now, we're seeing some uncharacteristic errors by York, if I can get that out.
Yes, uncharacteristic.
Sorrell slows. She serves that one once again. Tomei. Callie Sorrell digs that one up. Pushed back. English doing a great job. York able to keep that one alive. Wilkerson, a high roll shot all the way down five.
That's a fantastic shot by Brandy. So hard to defend because it's a high roll shot deep, and it's across her body. You're not expecting it to go to the deep corner there.
Brandy Wilkerson, one of the highest players. And a great, fast 31 shot there by Alec Derivage.
Love it. One of my favorites.
And as you used to love that play yourself, those are the plays that you said love to be back in there to do that. Miriam English now, she'll serve for the Gigi's. That just clears the tape. And what an ace serve. Miriam English just splits the back row there.
Just a nice aggressive float serve. Nothing fancy, just exactly what we need at this point in the set.
English once again, she unloads for the second time in a row, and we've seen this before, where Miriam English just gets on a roll serving her second straight ace to open up a 21-10 lead here for the Gigi's. And another very aggressive serve, third ace in a row.
I want to see if she can win this 5 ace in a row record. I really want to see it.
I tell you, I didn't think I would see this against York. I know Miriam English has the ability, but wow, she is unloading on this serve right now. I think she kept her trajectory the same, but she took a lot off of it and was sort of thinking, I'm going to drop this one in. Smart thought, but just not executed perfectly. But still, three aces.
Yeah.
Miriam English shows why she's in the top five of points per set. Steph Tyler keeps that one alive. Excellent turn by Derivage as Tyler keeps that one once again. And Kelsey English from the middle, she executes a perfect 51.
Yeah, just a beautiful play. I love seeing Kelsey back in the middle again. It just shows she's at home both in the middle and in the right side.
She certainly is.
And again, kudos to Steph for using her hands on both of those plays to dig that ball up.
Derivage, great job at just clearing the tape there. Sophie Chanel, I think, almost landed on her knees from a full jump. She almost landed on her knees to try to dig that ball. Steph Tyler able to pass that one a two all the way out to English. And she hits high, gets hands, but dug well. Arsovich able to keep that one alive as Wilkerson will roll that one down to five. And Chanel is just unable to connect on a 51.
Yeah, just took the call for contact on that one. Really great idea, though. One-on-one with the blocker. And if she could just get that contact down, I think that would be fantastic.
Yes. Brandy Wilkerson now will serve for York as York begins to make a move here in the second set. As she serves an ace right on the line. Brandy Wilkerson able to get that one. A very excited daddy on the sideline. Thinking that the call was out.
Yeah.
Brandy Wilkerson once again. She'll serve that one as Tyler passes that one up. Pushed back to English. And a smart play by Kelsey English to use the inside hand.
Yeah. That was very far off the net. And for Kelsey to just remain so composed and just stick with her technique on that one, uses the block, gets the point.
It is. And she'll bring up set point here as Kelsey English does a great job of putting fits for York there as Steph Tyler digs that one from the back row. A nice tip, but kept alive. And that one's going to land. Gigi's do a great job of rebounding here in the second set. They win it 25-14. Really being able to handle a potent offense from York, but it really, the tone was set in the second set, Kat, by a strong block.
Mm-hmm. I couldn't agree more. Obviously, we've talked about this. York's strength is their offense, the fact that they have so many different weapons, and they can really go anywhere on the court at any time. But when you have such a dynamic block with Ottawa U, it really shuts down their offense, and then what's left, right? So I couldn't be more proud of the changes these girls have made, and let's hope that they can keep rolling with it throughout this time.
Well, you talk about the impact that these two teams have had in the OUA. Six of these players are in the top 15 when it comes to points per set, and three of them hold the top three spots. Right now, Miriam English leading all the stats for the OUA at a 4.79 points per game. Brandi Wilkerson in second at a 4.46, and Kelsey English in third with a 4.15 percentage points per game. So we're all tied up here at 1 at Montpetit Hall. We want to thank you for joining us this afternoon as this premier match between the OUA's first place team in the East playing the second place team in the East. A heck of a matchup any single year. And I won't tell you the year that I started university, but I will tell you since that year, it's been very exciting whenever York comes into this gym.
They're just a fierce competitor year in and year out. And you can expect nothing less than the best. So it's just an exciting year to watch.
It is, indeed. And the Gigi's are looking to garnish their ceiling the same way that York has been able to. If anybody has gone in the Lions' home, you'll know that they barely have a roof because they were able to decorate their walls with so many banners for OUA championships. Within so many sports, they do a great job. But it's very, very interesting to see how well also the Gigi's did a great job of being able to handle that potent offense of the York Lions so far. So I don't think there's any surprise so far after two sets. Brandi Wilkerson leading with 5 kills, 3 errors, and 24 total attempts. On the Gigi side, no question. Miriam English already in double digits with 10 kills, 3, and total attacks 18. So she's already hitting at a .389 percentage so far in this match.
Yeah, and just beneath her, Kelsey English with 6 kills already in the match. And we've got to give it to Callie Soro also, coming in only in the second set, 3 kills already. So.
Well, Callie Soro did an unbelievable job of really lighting it up. I think when you talked about it, it was almost an injection of just fight when she came on the floor. And it is interesting. You made note of this earlier. We're talking about a first-year player right now. To be able to come in with that much fight and spirit, imagine this kid when she gets to fourth year, fifth year. So York will open it up here in the third set. And that dug well by York, kept alive. And that'll be put over free by Black. English able to dig that up as Tomei pushes that all the way back. And Derivaj unable to score on that step around. Point, York.
Looks like that ball just hung a little bit inside, so Alex was a little bit too far out. And that was kind of her only option. So hopefully Kira will be able to push the ball a little further out for her.
Excellent pass there, Kelsey English, as that one's pushed right in the hole. And, you know, Miriam did a great job there of also seeing the pot, but knowing it was high to the right of the pot. Very smart play.
So smart. So aggressive. It's not always about the big kill. Sometimes it's about outthinking your opponent.
And that one, Tomei serves that one. A fast attack with a block for the Gigi. Shuts that down once again. Dug by English. Tomei puts that up. And a very fast attack. Goodybash. Able to score for the Gigi's, and now you see that 51 offense from the Gigi's taking advantage of York.
About time, Bill.
Yes.
About time.
And I know you hold the middle offense very dear to your heart. That one catches the line. no fault there to Arcevic, as really that ball dropped as it went over her head.
It really did. I thought it was out 100%, and then looking at it, it just clung to that line.
Yes. Kiara Tomei, once again, she'll serve that one and handle Arcevic, able to get that one. Brandi Wilkerson unable to push that all the way out. And the Gigi's block, once again, after that adjustment of stepping a little bit far outside, has shut it down. Now, in all fairness to Wilkerson, that ball didn't get pushed out very far.
Not an ideal set.
Tomei, she'll serve that one. Arcevic once again. And once again, Michelle Pierce getting shut down. And really, the Gigi's block is impenetrable.
Right. You know, I like that block too. Miriam's hands were a touch later than we've seen, and I don't think Pierce was able to even see her block coming.
Yes.
So she thought she had an open seam there, and then Miriam just popped up the last second and shut it down.
It's an excellent blocking system right now that the Gigi's are using, and really putting on a clinic here. Right from the start of the second set, really made some adjustments and shut down this York offense. Right now in the third set, you're seeing four blocks straight by the Gigi's, and they've opened up a 5-1 lead here in the third.
Yes. You know, for the last, I'd say 3 years of my career, and just continuing now into this year, our identity is 100% serving and blocking. And when we get that rolling, they're unstoppable.
And that's what you need when you have York Lions rolling in here with the height and the skill that they have on this floor right now. When you look at that front row, that is a big front row right now. And very, very difficult to shut down. Kiara Tomei once again for the Gigi. She'll serve that one down to 5. Arcevic able to handle that one and kept well off the net. Sorrell keeps that one alive as Tyler puts that one up. Pushed right in the corner. Excellent shot. And that now is the 16th point that Miriam English has scored so far in this match.
Unbelievable game for Miriam. Like I said, I'm sure it's only going to continue to get better.
Tomei. Oh, that one caught the Gigi up court. Sailed out the back line.
After a big point like they just had to, it's always very tough to calm yourself down before that next serve.
It is. Alex Arcevic now serving for York. And Arcevic will serve that one to Tyler. She passes that one up off the net. All the way out to English. And English once again using the outside hand of Wilkerson. Point Gigi's.
Just a great swing by Kelsey.
Miriam English will assume the serving duties once again for the Gigi's as she puts that one over. Arcevic has no problem with that. Pushed 31 to Pierce. And another fast hit, but dug well by Tomei. That put up by Tyler. And that pushed in right over the head of the defense. There seems to be a front-back seam there.
Almost like a seam in between. Like you say, the front of the court and back of the court. Yeah. They're not really sure communication-wise.
English unloads that one once again. Arcevic able to pass that one outside. And that one kept alive. Looks like it might be a lift call or a double.
Just kind of an awkward play.
Yes.
I don't really think anybody's at fault there.
No. Kelsey English doing a great job of getting hands on that block. Looking like it would be late again, but closing well as Michelle Pierce takes over the serving. And that one just drops at the end. Steph Tyler unable to handle that. Michelle Pierce with the ace. So York still trails 4-8 here in the third set. And Pierce, and she serves that one long. That opens up a 5-point lead once again for the Gigi's. And that'll bring Alex Dillivage back to the line. Dillivage. Oh, just not able to get the roll of the tape there. It started out a foot below the height of the net. And it did come up, but it's not enough. Brandi Wilkerson now serving for York. She serves that as Kelsey English handles that all the way back. Nice hands, but great dig. Excellent job by Flemmer there. Miriam English keeps that one up. Sorrell just puts that high. Miriam English, high swing from the back row. As she sticks around to dig that ball. Put all the way up. Kelsey English, high shot deep to the court, way over the block. Great spot by Kelsey.
Exactly. It's just a great spot. I don't even think she 100% meant, she kind of whiffed on the ball a bit, but she put it in the right spot, and that's what counted.
And that'll bring Kelsey English back to serve for the Gigi's. She puts that right down to five. Arcevich handles that.
Ooh.
And that, very strange play. Wilkerson able to dig that ball. And back, a roll shot there. Tomei will handle that. As Chanel's able to push that, that's pushed deep, kept alive. Wilkerson, she tries to roll that deep. And that'll be an unforced error. That entire play didn't seem to have any rhythm at all for both sides.
You know, it almost looks as if they're getting a little tired.
Yes, yes. A few people trying to catch their breath.
I mean, it's easy for me to say I haven't worked out in 6 months.
We won't even go there for me, so. York getting a warning from the bench. And Kelsey English once again will serve. Arcevich able to pass that up. Pushed well outside to Black. Off the block of Tomei. Pushed back outside. And no touch on that ball. Sorrell unable to get a touch call. Ball might have been a little bit low and inside.
Yeah, and that's going to come with maturity for Callie. Knowing when she can swing hard and knowing when she has to fix the ball.
Very, very true. And that pushed all the way back. Chanel able to get that, but great dig by Black, kept alive, as she'll pass that one over free, and Tyler handles that one well. Miriam English, high shot, just misses that. Two people took a swing of that ball and missed.
Yeah, that was a lucky swing and a miss, for sure.
And that'll close it back to a four-point lead here. Gigi's still leading, 11-7 in the third. Jennifer Black serves that one down the line for one. And Sorrell tips that in the pot. Dug well by Arcevich. She tries to get herself back outside. Pushed outside. And Sorrell, sharp cross-court hit there, but dug well by Arcevich as she takes it down the line. And English digs that. Pushed all the way back. And through the hands, Sophie Chanel does a great job of scoring on the step around.
Yeah, great connection there between her and Setter. And also, I'd just like to point out, Callie, when we talked about her learning the difference of when to tip and when to swing hard, she just proved herself there in that rally, one tip and one hard swing.
A very mature, veteran-like play by Callie Sorrell, but unfortunately serves that one just long. And right now, that'll close York back to within four. Brittany Hopley now serving for York. Hopley serves that one to Steph Tyler. Handles that one well. Pushed well outside. Nice hands. Great dig by Black. Ball kept alive. Just put in the court. English digs that. And that's an excellent heads-up play by Michelle Pierce at the net to watch second hands of Tomei.
She's a fantastic blocker. I played against her last year. And she's, to be honest, she's probably one of my least favorite people to play against. Just
yes.
Because she's such a great blocker.
It's exactly right. That'll bring Hopley once again. She serves a bullet, but handled well by Tyler. Step around there by Chanel. And that one's dumped in the pot. And that one kept alive by Tyler. Pushed outside. English! Able to reach high and score. Miriam English proving why she's number one in points per set in the OUA.
Yeah, both her and Kelsey doing a fantastic job of using hands. Hitting high, and once again, just using the angle of the hit to make sure that ball goes out.
Yes. Sophie Chanel once again now serves for the Gigi's, and she goes down five. And that one blocked. And just unable to keep that one alive. That one going right in the pot off the block. And a great high swing by Arcevich.
Yep.
Kristen Dillon now, she'll serve for York. And she drops that one in. As Steph Tyler handles that one well. Pushed outside. Oh, Miriam English all over finding that seam in between Pierce and Wilkinson.
It's too bad. I don't think they'll be able to catch that on tape, but her arm swing is just so, so fast.
So fast. She's able to get that ball down because most people would have hit that in the net.
Oh, yeah.
As that ball just clears Kira Tome able to get that. A roll shot there. Kept alive as Billy Bash pushes that one back. Kelsey Ingles kept that, but nice dig by Steph Tyler. And that'll be a roll shot that drops in for Kelsey English. A heads-up roll shot. York won't be happy with that one.
No, you know, it wasn't just a roll shot. She really did added that
extended
extra snap.
Yes.
Just to make sure that it dropped right in the pot.
Yeah, agreed. Kiara Tome now. She'll serve. And no reaction from the passers of York. And that'll bring us to a technical timeout as Ottawa leads here 16-10.
My best right now, not to cheer directly into the microphone. I probably should apologize
for
people listening right now.
Yes. It's and as we know, there's never a York match that's not going to be emotional between Ottawa and York. And really, right now, we're seeing that here. Right now, the Gigi's still doing such a great job of moving around and moving their serve around and being able to keep that aggressive serve going.
Yeah. And I think York and Ottawa have two very different emotional styles when they're on the court. York's a louder team. They're very energetic. You can hear a little bit of chirping from the bench, and that's their style. Whereas the Gigi's are a little bit more even-keeled, and I think both teams are doing a good job of sticking with their identities, but I think it's just so nice to see Ottawa remain composed.
Yes. And that's what they knew they had to do here today if they had any chance against this first place team coming in. And really, they've done a great job so far. York coming out. If you're just joining us, right now, we're in the third set. And the Gigi's right now sporting a 16-10 lead. This match tied 1-1. York came out very aggressive in the first set. And the Gigi's came back with a solid blocking set in the second. Now Kiara Tome will look to serve once again for the Gigi's. And that's a tough error coming out from a timeout.
A certain coach of mine always taught us you never want to miss a serve right out of a timeout. Yeah.
Is he about to clinch your arm right now?
He is.
Arsovich serves that one down one. And that one. And two unforced errors straight by the Gigi's. Close York back to within four. A low set, 31.
A low set, and I think Alex could have done a little bit more to just stay open.
Keep it open.
Better.
Exactly. And Kelsey English unloads on that one. Miriam English, sorry. And a very high hit there. And you know what? Great play there by Wilkerson to reach high over that block. And Michelle Pierce to finish it off. Great job. York has been solid since the timeout, and the Gigi's been making two unforced errors.
It's not often that you see a girl who's able to actually just reach right over our block.
Exactly.
So we've got to give Granny credit for that.
And the solid block there, the Gigi's shuts that one down. Wilkerson able, but Tyler digs that one up, and a great dig. And that one dug there. Pushed back outside. Black able to keep that one alive. Tome keeps that one up. Vitevage able to go there. And what a smart play. Miriam English coming across and going back outside with a tip.
I love it. All of the players were rushing in there for the scramble ball, and she just saw that opening and took advantage.
So Miriam English stops the bleeding here as she takes the ball back to serve. And what a time to unload one of her aces.
The float from where we're sitting, and that was a tough one to pass.
That was a really tough one to pass as Miriam English, she alones her third ace here in this match so far, and once again just clears the tape. And Michelle Pierce, what an execution of a 31 to get that through the block.
Yeah, finding the seam there. Another player for York who's just so high up there and really athletic and knows her position well.
Kristen Dillon doing a great job of executing that offense right to Pierce to find the seam. Wong now once again back in the match as a serving specialist. English gets handcuffed on that.
Again, just a big technical serve. All they need right now is a strong float. And if she did a really good job of executing that.
It is. And any team will tell you, on a shank, that's probably the worst place for the ball to go, right up to four, because no player's back there, everybody's already backed off, and no chance for anybody to get to it.
Yeah.
match. So Coach Lionel Woods calls a timeout here. As we get to the later stages of this set, the Gigi's still maintaining a three-point lead, up 18-15. But York right now starting to come alive
right.
since the technical timeout.
Yeah, I was going to say, a three-point lead sounds pretty significant at this point in the set, but it doesn't feel that way at all.
No.
York definitely has the tools to get back into this, so they're going to have to, the Gigi's are going to have to stay on their game here.
Yes. Momentum definitely swinging towards York's side as Wong takes the ball. And she does a great job of serving that. Tyler keeps that one alive. And Sorrow hits that one right in the block. And now all of a sudden we see the York block rolling a little bit more. But again, the Gigi's unable to pass the ball. Wong serves that one. And not a much better pass by Tyler as that one's pushed back. And a tip right over. Again, there seems to be a seam between the front back.
Yeah. You know, I think in teams like York, where they're so big, you expect the block to get a lot. But then you have a team that's as smart as the Gigi's. They're going to put those balls short. So the people in the back of the court are going to have to be on their toes.
That's a great point. Duddy Vash now serves that one. And she sails that one out the end line. York closes to within two. Gigi's still leading 19-17 here in the third set. As Brandy Wilkerson, she serves for York. That one goes right to six. Steph Tyler puts that one up. Sorrow, nice cross-court shot. And she keeps that one alive as York puts that ball over. Push back outside. Sorrow, cross-court, strong shot.
Yep. And as you see there, just the organization of the Gigi's really splits up that block for York. So Callie gets the one-on-one there, and it's an easy put away for her.
It is. So the Gigi's open up their three-point lead once again, 20-17, as Kelsey English takes the ball to serve. She serves that right down to six, and Arcevic handles that one, pushed back outside. Black uses the high hands, pushed back outside. Ooh. Sophie Chanel does a great job of step around, but dug well by York. And Chanel got all of that, but just in the pot, Gigi's defense very set in deep.
Yep. Again, everybody's expecting strong hits on both sides of the court, so it catches you off guard sometimes when things get caught on the block or somebody puts a chip in there.
It does. Jennifer Black now serves for York, and that one just kept alive as English roll shots that, kept in the middle, and that one blocked again. Once again, pushed outside. Sorrell's able to keep that up, but Wilkerson digs that. Pushed back outside. And a great job, Arcevic, keeping that one alive. Miriam English unable to turn that one over. And Arcevic deserves that point because she had to make an acrobatic move to keep that one in.
She did.
So here we are in the third set. Once again, 1 point separating these teams. The Gigi's hold on to a 20-19 lead. Jennifer Black serves that one as Steph Tyler passes that one up and Chanel pushes that one in. Wilkerson digs that. Pushed all the way back. And that one just a little bit too low. Brittany Hobley not able to handle that one. But from this angle, Kat, you can really see how fast York runs their offense.
Yeah, it's extremely fast. And it's so inspirational to see that the Gigi's are catching up on this block.
It's
true. And taking control of it.
It is.
Ooh.
And a very rare error by Dylan there. That one coming off the top of her hands. Opening up the Gigi's to a three-point lead once again, 22-19. As Callie Sorrell serves that one. And she sails that one long. Again, aggressive serving, but at this point has to be mixed a little bit with cutting down the unforced error.
Like we talked about, there's crucial times during a match, whether it's after a timeout or when you're only off by 2 points, that you really need to make sure that you're getting those serves in. So, I mean, there's being aggressive, but there's also being smart.
That's right. They had a die now. She'll make an appearance here in this third set, as she's already come in once to serve. And she unloads a rocket, but Steph Tyler handles that. And a good heads-up play. Kiera Tomei trying to get that one over on second, but the York block ready for that. And that closes it back to within one. My co-host not too happy with that last play.
Not so much.
So the GGs cling to a one-point lead here in the third set, 22-21. York inching their way back. And really right now, the GGs will look to come out of this timeout, this next point, Pat, critical in looking at the flow of this set. If the GGs can get that 23-21 lead, be a big difference, then 22 home.
It really would. I think we really just need to go back to our style right now. That play that York just got the point on, that's York's style.
Yes.
That is not our style.
Yep.
I want to see some organized volleyball from our side of the court, some calm play, and some aggressive play.
That's right. As Dai, she serves that one deep once again. That one handled by the GGs. Pushed well outside. And that one dug well by York. Pushed over. Miriam English again does a great job of continue shot, but blocking the ball. And that's that 23-21 lead that the GGs were looking for after that timeout. As Veronique Caillé comes in as a serving defensive specialist. And she lets that one drop in. Great ball there to keep alive. And Callie Soro unable to dig that ball up that squeezed through the block. Alex Archevich doing a great job of pushing that one through. 23-22 Ottawa GGs. Here in the third set, Kristen Dillon will serve for York. And Steph Tyler does a great job of that one. And that one pushed way too far outside. Miscommunication there, for sure.
Yep.
Miriam English expecting an inside ball, but Kiara Tomei pushing that way too far out.
And just like that, we're tied up again here at 23-all.
23-all as Dillon will take the ball. She'll serve that. And that, not a good time for a service error by Kelsey English. And for the first time in this set, York assumes the lead at the most critical point, 24-23. Steph Tyler passes that one well, pushed well outside. Billy Vash hits that, but blocked well. A joust at the net. And Kiara Tomei unable to keep that one alive. York does a great job of surging back. And the GGs will not be pleased with letting that set slip away after the lead that they had.
There are a lot of people who are not pleased with that set, though.
Including the one sitting right next to me. And I will let everybody know at home, because they can't see, I'm going to be beaten and bruised by the end of this set, because I keep getting hit after plays. But as we know it, York leads this match right now 2-1. And I think right now there's nobody on the GG side that doesn't know that they let that one slip away.
Absolutely. I mean, as long as we can get our serve back in there, I think that's going to be our key point right here. Just because I really don't think service even has been that bad.
No.
Obviously, there's some points we can improve on. But I really think serving slipped up a bit there, and we let off the gas pedal a bit.
It did. And then really, we saw that after the timeout, you know,
yeah.
How frustrating it is. And, I mean, we both know it from both of these teams. But you got to remember, the GGs had a 22-19 lead in that set.
Yeah.
And really allowed it to slip away just on some unforced errors and not playing aggressive, starting as coming out from a timeout and missing a serve. You often wonder, all your years that you played for me and you played for the GGs,
mm-hmm.
You were trying to understand why I have gray hair.
Right.
Now I think it's quite clear as why I have gray hair.
Can you see mine coming in? They're there, Bill.
I can.
They're indeed. Real.
I can indeed.
You know, Melissa Morelli actually came up with a nice term for gray hair. Her father refers to them as Arctic blonde. So I think that's what I'm going to go with from now on.
Arctic blonde.
Arctic blonde.
What an excellent color that is. Melissa delivers our stats for that third set.
Speak of the devil.
And I mean, really, no surprise right now, but wow, 15 kills for Miriam English as she leads this match, and also in double digits, Kelsey English right behind her at 10. And we see good distribution And that's what you talked about all match. You talked about the distribution for York right now.
Mm-hmm.
Arcevich with 6 kills. Pierce with 5 kills. Black with 3 kills. Brandy Wilkinson with 6 kills.
Yep.
Right across the board, you see excellent distribution. And really, that's what the York offense has been known for all along. So as we get ready for this first set, the fourth set coming forward from Montpetit Hall, and your Ottawa Gigis are hosting the York Lions this afternoon, trailing 2-1. It's been a seesaw battle, as everybody would expect the top two teams to have. Both of these teams right now maintaining a rank within the top 10, York at 4th in the country, and the Gigi's doubling them up in 8th. And a win here by the Gigi's would definitely upset that ranking.
Mm-hmm.
Kiara Tomei, she'll take the ball for the Gigi's and open up this 4th set here. Tomei serves that one in the net. And that wasn't even an aggressive miss.
No, I don't like that. Not on the first point.
Not on the first point, for sure. Arcevich serves that. Tyler passes that one out. Pushed well outside.
Ooh, too bad.
English unable to get that off the net. And 2 unforced errors starting up this set for the Gigi's.
It's too bad, because that was really just a clutch pass by Steph Tyler there.
That one dug well by English off of Arcevich.
And
she does a great job of coming back there. Sharp cross court hit. And the Gigi's will look to start to roll here.
Gotta like that when you start and finish the play. A great pass by Kelsey and then a great kill.
And her sister Miriam English will now take the ball as she just clears the tape. Arcevich able to take that.
Ooh.
And that one just missing the 31. So York comes back with their unforced error. And this set is tied up at 2.
You know, we talk about aggressive serving and aggressive blocking. That there was an aggressive set.
It was.
And I have absolutely no problem with that from the York side. I mean, you're going to have those misses, but when that connects, we'd be in a lot of trouble.
You're right. Miriam English unable to get that one over. She serves that one in the tape. Michelle Pierce will now serve. And she comes back with her own service error. So here we are. We're tied at 3-3 in the 4th set, and maybe fatigue setting in, because out of the 6 points, 4 of them have been unforced errors.
Right.
Alec Derivage serves that one, but Arcevich able to handle that, and that's dug by Tomei, kept alive by Dillon. Dillon will push that one deep as Miriam English handles that. And a wonderful run by Sophie Chanel out of the middle. Catches everybody off guard on the 51. Great job.
I'm sorry, but if you're going to put a free ball over, you cannot just put a simple ball like that to Miriam English. She's going to set something up. And just like that, Sophie gets a huge kill.
A huge kill indeed. Alex Bidigash, she'll serve once again. And that handcuffs Arcevich. Pushed back outside. Wilkinson hits high over the block, but Miriam English digs that. And Sorrell tips that one in the pot, but dug well once again.
Oh.
Kelsey English comes forward with a solid block with Sophie Chanel.
Great block by Kelsey there.
And that opens up 5-3 lead right now for the Gigi's in the 4th set. Alex Derivage continues to serve here for the Gigi's. Does a great job. Passed well by Arcevich. And that one, uncontested for the Gigi's. A rare play. Nobody reacted to that ball. Brandy Wilkinson now. She serves and gets ready to serve here for York. There's that outside. Kelsey English keeps that one alive. Soro reaches high. Great job. Excellent heads-up play by both teams as that one's rolled alive. Steph Tyler keeps that one, pushed well outside. Sorrell keeps that up, and four contacts called there as Sorrell's unable to keep that one alive. Looking for the fire from the rookie here in the 4th set. As that error allows York to tie this at 5-5 as Wilkinson serves that. But Tyler passes up, and an excellent run on 51 by Doug Welt. An excellent job there by Tyler as she keeps that one alive. Tipped over by the Gigi's. And roll shot, but Miriam English is there. Pushed well outside. Sorrow, high shot.
There we go.
And a smart play by the rookie to use hands. Point, Gigi's.
You know, I think Sophie is doing an excellent job in the middle here with what she's being set. But it would be nice if she could get a few higher balls. I think her and Alex are just two very different middles. And Sophie's just so much higher and longer that those couple extra inches would mean the difference between a swat and a strong kill.
I totally agree. As you see a strong swat there from New York Lions as they run a very potent 51 off that play. Bringing Jennifer Black to the line. Black serves that one deep, but handled well by Kelsey English. Pushed out by Sorrow and tipped by Brandy Wilkerson. Takes that one. Pushed well outside and blocked by Tomei once again. Pushed outside. Tomei just unable to turn that ball. An excellent shot there by Alex Arcevic.
I think Tomei realized that she was going to go line. She made the adjustment, but she was just moving her block, and that's where she was able to get wiped off of.
Yes. And the strong play right now, Caleb L. Hammond in, known as a very strong hitter. Very smart heads-up play by Kiara Tomei to go up, fake her hands, and pull them back down. Bell Hammond now, she'll serve for the Gigi's. Bell Hammond does a great job of serving that, but Arcevic handles that. And right through the block. Excellent shot there, Brittany Hopley.
I think we see there just another case of a moving block.
Yes. Moving block, creating a seam, and Hopley taking advantage of it as she now takes the ball and gets ready to serve for York. Hopley, she serves that one. Steph Tyler handles that, passed well, all the way out. Chanel's able to keep that one going. And Arcevic is lighting it up here in the fourth set for York as there's a few holes that are being created right now in that GG block. Brittany Hopley, she serves that one out. Marion English has no problem with that.
Ooh.
And what an excellent 61 run. Beautiful play by Sophie Chanel.
That's one of her specialties. She's just so great at that fast set right behind the setter's head. She connects so well with it. It's one of her best shots.
Well, and you talk about another player that's going to be so potent in years to come, only a second-year player.
Yeah.
She serves that one high and deep. And unloads. As Kelsey English just bowls through the row of seats to go after the ball. That's dedication, absolutely. Great serve there by York as that's passed up by Tyler. Pushed out and tipped, but Dylan keeps that one alive. And that'll be a free ball pushed over as Bell Hammond pushes that one up. And that's a step around. Betty Vash keeps that alive with a tip. Pushed all the way inside. Wilkinson. And English unable to keep that one up. Not a good flow to the last series of the Gigi's offense.
No, it seems to me like we've lost a bit of our blocking as well.
Yes.
It's really allowing York to pull ahead right now.
Kristen Dillon gets ready to serve for York. She goes right down six, and Kelsey English handles that one well outside to Miriam English. And that's the offense. Miriam English scoring through the block.
I'd be very curious to see right now what service heat stats look like for the Gigi's. They just seem to be on point. I've been seeing three after three after three.
Agreed. Kiara Tomei, she serves that one down. Arcevic, great job. Arcevic has just been passing like crazy.
Yeah.
Great job. Arcevic serves once again. She takes that. Miriam English just keeping that one alive. Kelsey English, very high step there. She just sneaks that right by the block. Gigi's trail 12-10 here in the fourth. Miriam English gets ready once again, and she serves that one down one.
Yes.
And heads the line for her fourth ace of this match.
You're also making me a little nervous right now. I can't see that line very well.
I know. As long as we see that flag going down.
Yep.
Slammer able to handle that one well off of English as she gets that hit all the way outside. Kelsey English, very high extension. And the Gigi's erased the York lead. We tie it up 12 all here. Basically at the hand of the English twins.
What else is there?
Yes. And that one sailing long for Miriam English.
That's okay. She got us back in there.
Yes.
And a little bit of hard work, we can get that lead back again.
So Michelle Pierce will look to open up a lead here again, beyond 1 point, as she serves to Steph Tyler, all the way back to English. A sharp cross-court shot misses for English. Another unforced error for the Gigi's. And York opens up a 2-point lead, 14-12. Pierce for York. She'll serve that. Tyler, unable to handle that. Service ace. Pierce doing a great job there with the serve.
She does really have a great serve. Yeah, I mean, Steph's been on her game today with passing, so it just goes to show you how good her serve really is.
It is. Although Pierce puts that one in the net. Closes it back within two. Gigi's trailing 15-13 here in the fourth set. Alec Derivage now takes that one. She serves down one, but Flemmer handles that well. And a great dig, way to keep it alive.
I'm sorry. That's an imaginary call.
Not quite sure where the four call was there.
Hmm.
But I guess Malcolm Rousseau saw something we didn't.
Wow.
And that brings us to the technical timeout here in the fourth set. 16-13, York leads it. They also lead this match 2-1. Good crowd here at Montpetit Hall for this first and second place matchup for the OUA East. As both of these teams are really performing at the level that most people thought they would.
Yeah, absolutely. Already, I think this is the longest game I've attended in Montpetit Hall, so.
Well, my voice is definitely knowing it's the longest one so far. Both teams coming back out onto the floor right now. Brandi Wilkerson will serve for York. And she serves that one in the middle of the net.
She has such an unconventional serve. And when it's on, it's really on. But when it's off...
That serve has given so many team fits.
Yeah.
Kelsey English for the Gigi's. She serves that down six. And that one handcuffs Arcevich. But Tyler passes that one well for the Gigi's. And a nice step around, a low set. That one just kept alive as Black's going to roll shot that in. Steph Tyler passes that one up, pushed outside. Caleb L. Hammond reaches high, but dug well by Black. Tyler keeps that one alive, pushed in the middle. And great dig there by Flemmer. Back outside to Black.
There we go.
And Black, unable to snap over on that ball. Gigi's close to within one off that error. They still trail by one. 16-15.
A little bit of organization there by the Gigi's. Not as sloppy as we've seen earlier in the set. And we get that point.
And sister Kelsey English donates an ace of her own. And if we look at the aces here by the English twins in this match, very impressive at five so far between them. Kelsey serves that one high as Flemmer passes that one up and has trouble with that. Wilkerson will roll shot that as English passes that all the way up outside. Bell Hammond does a great job of using outside hands.
You know, I played with Caleb for three years of my career, and she's just developed so much. In her first year, she would have never made that play. And just she's just grown so much as a player to use the hands. And you really saw her turn, hit the hands,
yep.
and wipe out. Great play by Kayla.
Yeah, great play. We always talked about her needing to be a little bit more dynamic as a player.
Yep.
And really now, she's coming to that point of her career. And that will hand the Gigi's elite 17-16 as they've been pretty dominant in the middle portion of this set so far. York coming out and rolling after sneaking away with that third set.
Yep.
Kelsey English back once again now serving for the Gigi's. English, she serves that. That one handled by Arsenevich, but dug by Tyler off the hit. English all the way up high, kept alive by Chanel. Pushed back to English, kept alive once again by Chanel, and Bell Hammond will keep that one up as English unable to get that one over. Good job by York there to keep their block pretty unified off some unconventional hitting.
Yep.
Zones from the Gigi's.
Yeah, and you know what? That's a good point for the Gigi's, too. It didn't go their way, but great hitting.
Jennifer Black, she'll serve that for York. As that one stepped around, well dug by Black. Wilkerson, high roll shot, but handled well by Tyler as that's pushed outside. And Bell Hammond, once again, uses high hands. Great job by Taylor Bell Hammond coming in. Contribute to the offense here from the left side.
You know, when we were back in practice with Kayla, we always just make jokes that she could probably explode someone's fingers if she wanted to. And she keeps hitting that way.
Well, she exploded that ball at the end line. Now we'll see Wong back in for York. Wong, a serving specialist for York, has come in three sets now and does a great job there, but English handles that one well, all the way out to Miriam English. Off of hands. Boy, let me tell you, when you're good, you got it. And she just finds a way to score.
Just so much fun to watch her play.
And that'll be bring Veronique Caillé in to serve for the Gigi's. IA, she'll serve that one to five. Arsenevich handles that one well. Pushed back to Pierce and just touched. Tomei keeps that one up. Bell Hammond roll shots that one in. Dug well by Wong. Pushed outside. Bell Hammond does a great job of digging that ball. Pushed outside to English. And kept alive by York. IA pushes that one up. Oh, Miriam English just unable to capitalize on that.
But once again, just so much good in that rally.
Oh, there was a lot of good play. Excellent digging by Kayla Bell Hammond to keep that one alive.
Just some really minor execution errors. But other than that, just solid play all around.
Agreed. So no surprise that we're tied up at 19 here in the fourth set. An excellent match here between these two teams. The Gigi's looking to tie this matchup, two sets all, as York sports a lead right now, 2-1. Both teams going over their final bits of information on what they have to focus on for the rest of this set. York hoping to close it out here, not letting the Gigi's take it to a fifth. But the Gigi's want to do whatever they can to push the limits in the sets. Veronique keeps that one alive.
Yes!
And what a great scramble play from that ball. Veronique Caillé starting that pass over her head.
It's a great set, too.
Wow.
Yeah.
2019, Gigi's. Piero Tomei, she'll serve. And that one just drops. What a beautiful drop ball.
Yeah, I did not think that one was even going to make it over the
table. I didn't think so either.
Wow.
Kiara Tomei once again for the Gigi's. She serves that one. She rails that one over to the back of the court. She has struggled today from the service line. A lot of errors.
Yeah, you know, she often is one of the players who goes on runs from the Gigi's.
Yes.
So it's too bad to see her struggle a little bit with that skill today.
Alex Arshavich once again. Kaye handles that one well, pushed all the way back. And English! Uncontested, no block.
Right.
Not the player you do not want to have a block on.
No.
And she'll take over the serve here.
Oh, shoot.
And that one just long as well.
You'll
see a double.
No,
not an aggressive serve at this point for sure. Double sub now. As we see Hopley come back into the match. Die serving. Die serves that one, and English handles that well, all the way up to Tomei, pushed back to English. High off the hands, and she does a great job of using a high hand shot.
You know, from this angle, I saw the ball being set, and that was such a strong sealed block that I really thought that we were going to just have to play some defense on offside and pick it up. But she did such an amazing job of using the hands.
Amazing job for sure. As Alec Derivage now will serve for the Gigi's. And she serves that down one. And that one is dropping like crazy. Randy roll shots that one all the way out to Kelsey English. But well blocked and dug once again by English. Pushed out by English. And that one kept alive once again by Tomei. As English will just keep that one alive, push back, and a nice fast shot, but dug well. English will keep that alive. Free ball once again for York, pushed up well. A great scramble play by the Gigi's, but you knew giving York free ball after free ball was going to cost them.
Yeah. York really loves to use that middle, and they push the ball around well.
Yes.
They chuck a lot of their balls, and
yep.
I just don't feel like we're completely prepared for that.
22-23 as Wilkerson serves. Handled well. Very tough execution there as Chanel unforced error on the 31. Difficult choice in set there. And now this set all tied up at 23. Once again, saw herself in this position back in the third set. Very tight time to have an unforced error like that.
Yeah, you know, it was a gutsy set on our side, and I mean, it didn't work out for us.
Didn't work out.
So we got to push here for 2 points and really make it count in that fifth set that
yes.
is most definitely coming.
That's right. And if it's not, folks, I'm going to be running for the hills because I feel my partner will beat me up. Randy Wilkerson serving for York. This set tied up 23-all. York looking to close it here. Wilkerson serves that and handled well by English. Pushed all the way out.
Oh.
Bill Hannon fires that one down and gives the Gigi's a 24-23 lead. Kelsey English, she'll serve for the set. English floats that one and a great pass. Excellent one. Hopley keeps it alive with an excellent 51 run.
You know, we haven't seen that shot from York Middle yet, so that's a great time to work that one out.
Jennifer Black will serve here.
It's out. Oh, no.
And that one kept alive. Oh, my goodness. Sophie Chanel shutting down an overpass block. That looked like it was York's point for sure.
You know, if Lindley taught me one thing in my 5 years as a Gigi, is that on a tight ball, you do not swing away.
No, you do not. As Kayla Bell-Hammond unloads, as Clemmer handles that, and off the hands,
great
but
job.
Bell-Hammond does a great job of digging that up. Pushed outside, Miriam English, she finishes it for the Gigi's. And we're tied up, two sets all. What a great finish to that set. The Ottawa Gigi's take it
26-24, tying this matchup, two sets all. I can guarantee I will not have a voice tomorrow.
You know, I wasn't even nervous at all.
No,
I knew that was coming.
I didn't realize I had to wear hockey equipment to do webcasting, but it looks like I have to.
So both teams are going to talk it over now. We're getting ready for the fifth set here. Just waiting for the captains and the coin toss to see who's going to get served this fifth set. Now, we've seen changes for both teams, just in their tactics throughout the game. A lot of blocking changes from the GGs, and I think that's really been the key to success here. Right now, you can see just in Lionel's attitude in the team huddle, he's just really trying to get his team fired up and ready for this fifth set, focused. So this is definitely an exciting match to be a part of and to be watching. And once again, I apologize to anyone at home if I've been cheering directly into the microphone. I really can't help myself.
So if you're just joining us now, ladies and gentlemen, you have missed one heck of a match to this point. This match tied up, two sets all. York coming out, winning the first one, dominating it. GG's coming back and dominating the second. Maintaining a lead for the GG's all the way through the third, and York stole it after 23. And in the fourth set, York ready to close it out, but the GG's come back and find a way to win 26-24. And we head to a fifth set here in Montpetit Hall. We talk about domination in a match. Miriam English leads this match with 20 kills. Kelsey English behind her with 14. Thanks for the encouragement on my voice. I will keep going. If they don't quit, I won't either.
I was just about to say, if they can pull through this fifth set, Bill, I believe in you.
Exactly. Thank you. Brandi Wilkerson leads right now. Actually, no. No surprise. Alex Archibald leading. She has just caught fire here. Coming onto the floor, taking the spot of Melissa, and really doing an unbelievable job.
You know, I really didn't see that coming. You always see Michelle Pierce and Brandy really just taking charge, and obviously Melissa, who's injured. And so for somebody new to come in and just really fill that spot, good honor.
I agree. Tomei will open it here in the fifth set.
There we go.
Nice run, but good block by Didivash in the middle. Pushed back outside. Wilkerson shot, but dug by Tyler. Pushed up outside. English kept alive by York. Miriam English pushes that up as she crosses over, and again the GGs open up the scoring here with an X. Miriam English scoring her 21st kill of the match.
Not bad at all.
Romay serves that one, and that one passed well.
Wow.
Tyler digs that one up. English high off a hand.
There we go.
Wilkerson unable to block that as Miriam English reaches high. 22 kills for Miriam English.
Great swing from Miriam and great pickup by Steph to pick up what was that, a standing tip?
Pretty well. Tomei, once again, she serves that one. And that one handled by Arsevich. She'll put that one in free. Bell Hammond passes that up, pushes outside. English tips that one, but dug well. Didivash, everybody sort of holding their breath there, looking to see what the call would be.
Yeah. You just really got to be careful on those tight plays. Yeah. Just, you don't want to make an error on something that's out of your control anyway.
But the GGs open up a 3-0 lead here as Tomei serves that one. And she goes right back at Clemmer. Wilkinson blocked once again, but she digs her own ball. And that one's put up. Dylan will put that in. Nice cross-court shot there by English. Keep that one alive. Wilkerson, high shot. Steph Tyler keeps that alive. And a great ball up from Miriam English. She takes that one down the line. What a shot by Miriam English.
Fantastic shot. and quite an interesting set by Kira. I think that was a flat set, and it somehow worked out beautifully. So, good on her.
Worked out beautifully for the Ottawa Gigi's, as they're doing everything right here so far in the fifth set. Right now, the Gigi's enjoy a 4-0 lead here in the fifth set.
I just got a text from my mom, so she thinks we're doing great. So thank you, Mom.
Wonderful. We both get those texts, just to let you know.
I guess I could also comment on the fact that she said the game was exciting, but...
Yes, exactly. All in the commentating, Kat. All in the commentating. Tomei, once again, she serves that, and that dug well.
Ooh.
And yeah. Michelle Pierce opens up the scoring here in the fifth with an exclamation point.
Ooh.
What a shot. Arsovich, she takes that one. As Miriam English passes that one up all the way out. English, high shot. And that scores. And that's a 5-1 lead for the Gigi's. Miriam English now back serving for the Gigi's. As she'll look to unload one of her weapons. Does. A great job there. Good dig. Steph Tyler keeps that alive. A free ball over to York. And again. Michelle Pierce just destroying Otto on the 51. But now she goes to the back row and serves.
It seems like there was a bit of miscommunication there between the middle blocker and right side blocker Kelsey. They both seem to share a bit of the duties, so
yes.
I think it can be a little difficult sometimes.
Bell Hammond, high shot there. And that one hit well by York, deep in the court. Now, right back in the set, 5-3, Ottawa still leads. Michelle Pierce serving. And she serves that deep, and Steph Tyler passes that one up, pushed all the way back. English, roll shots that, out of bounds, and another unforced error by the Gigi's.
Yep. They just really need to clean it up here, focus up. It's not the end of the world, they're still up.
Yep. So very streaky so far here in the fifth. As Steph Tyler takes that one, passes that all the way up to English. And that's a great dig there. Denny Dash fights that one, but unable to get that one over as she loses the joust at the net. Great job by Brittany Hopley to fight through that point and tie it up here at 5. Bell Hammond getting handcuffed by that ball. And she'll pass that one over free, going deep. York with the free ball, put up another 51. And Hopley, she contributes as that 51 set three times so far has taken the Gigi's by surprise.
Yeah, I'm not okay with that.
No.
They've hit the same ball three times in the same spot.
They should be right on top.
We need to get on top
ball.
Of this one.
Callie Sorrow back into this match.
Great
and that, Miriam English, great balls. Callie Sorrow is able to take that. Passed up well by Black. And a bit of miscommunication there on the GD defense. And now we see 7 straight points by York. They lead 7-5. Michelle Pierce still serving. Steph Tyler takes that one. A great pass. And English. Great shot there by Arsovich as Steph Tyler keeps that one alive and pushed by Denigaj but kept alive by Arsovich. Hopley takes that one. That's put up to English and she scores strongly on that ball.
Great swing by Kelsey, but you really got to give it to Kira there on her setting choices. One-on-ones all day long.
She did a great job. Good selection. And brings the Gigi's back to within one. Alec Derivage once again. She serves that one and handcuffs York on that one. All the way up. Wilkerson takes that. Miscommunication again by the Gigi's between Chanel and Tomei.
I've complimented her all season on this. She's not afraid to make gutsy sets.
Exactly.
And I don't know if that would be my tactic right now. So I'm admiring her, but I'm also very nervous.
Yes. Yes.
Be interesting to see where this one's going to lead.
Yep.
As York leads 8-6 here in the fifth set. Very strong play by both sides. As this match is shaping up to be everything that we thought it would be. Brandi Wilkerson ready to serve once again for York. The officials just checking the lineup.
Yeah, as we saw in our last game here at home, that lineup comes into play. So.
That made a big difference at the end of the fourth set. Wilkerson. She'll serve that to Tyler. Tyler able to take that.
Yes.
And again, Kelsey English doing a great job. One-on-one.
You know, with that one-on-one with Kelsey, she's so high. She's able to hit it almost straight down. So when they have a one-on-one, that defense is really going to want to step up.
It is. And that one, English does a great job of that. Sophie Chanel blocks that one. Goes different speed. And the GGs score their second point in a row, tying this set up at 8. Arcevich again passes well for that. And that one hit out of bounds. Third straight point for the GGs, and it hands the lead back to them.
Great call by Kelsey to let that one go.
Very good call. Kelsey English now. She serves that one into the tape. And that'll tie it up at 9. Jennifer Black now serving for York. Tyler handles that one well. Pushed up all the way up. Sorrell's able to get that, but dug well by Arcevich. Pushed outside. Tyler digs that. Kept alive. And that one kept back in the court.
Oh, come on. That's outrageous.
That one hit all the way in the court. A lot of people very confused at that.
That's not the cleanest attack I've
not
ever seen.
Not the cleanest attack, for sure. But regardless, that gets York the lead 10-9 here in the fifth. So here we are, timeout in the fifth set. My voice, very excited that there's not a sixth set. Both of us have spent most of this match yelling, very loud environment. Excellent match so far, as York leads here in the fifth set, 10-9. Jennifer Black serving for York. Tyler passes that one up. And that one kept alive.
Oh.
Kept up. Wilkerson. She'll get
Thank
called
you.
On the lip.
Now that's the call I was looking for in the last play.
That one held in her hand just a little bit too long.
You can't come from behind your head and push the ball forward.
10-all. First team to 5. Callie Sorrell serves that one as Flemmer takes that.
Ooh.
And that one dug well. Chanel keeps that one alive. Hit cross court, but Black digs that. Pushed all the way out. And what a shot! Arcevich able to unload.
You know, I have a theory that when a call isn't called against you, you'll end up losing that point anyway. So I think we had a bit of a double there from Sophie in the middle.
Yep.
So York really earned that point.
Yes.
We'll give it to him.
Yes. 11-10. Wong back in to serve for York. Wong serves that. Tyler passes that well. Pushed outside to English. High shot off the hands for sure. Miriam English continues her domination in this match. Veronique Kaye back in to serve here for the Gigi's. Fifth set, tied up at 11. Kaye serves that one deep, and Black just able to keep that one alive. That'll be a free ball for the Gigi's, pushed all the way out. And that one's going to land for the Gigi's. An excellent step around there by Derivage.
I like that zone. Just
that
right
was
six,
a
right
wonderful shot. Kaye, once again, she'll serve that, and Black handles that. Not a great pass. Wilkerson, high shot, blocked, but dug, kept alive by York. Long will put that over free as English passes it up to Tomei, pushed out. All the way, shot, cross court, Miriam English. 13-11, Gigi's.
You know, some people lead through emotion and through their words, and some people lead through their actions, and I think Miriam's just such a great example of somebody who does both. You just see her excitement after that play, but also her composure to be able to make that shot and just lead her team.
Agreed. And you see the leadership here today. Right now, the Gigi's leading 13-11 in the fifth set. Besides the first two sets, this match being very tight, coming down to the wire on every point at the end of the set. No difference here in the fifth. Veronique Kaye continues to serve for the Gigi's. Kaye serves that one. Handled well by Arcevic. And an overpass. That is point English.
Once again, we'll give that point to Ling Lee as well. He,
yes.
He really patented that move.
Yep. Kaye now will serve for the match for the Gigi's. She unloads and Black does a great job of handling that. And the Gigi's defeat the number one York Lions. This match is in the history books. The Ottawa Gigi's defeat York in five. 15-11. What an incredible match, Kat, for the Ottawa Gigi's.
I mean, I obviously could not be happier with the outcome. They made it really exciting for everybody at home. Obviously, I had no doubt in my mind the entire game that we were going to come out with a win here, and I just couldn't be more proud.
Absolutely phenomenal job by your hometown Ottawa Gigi's this afternoon as they defeat York in five sets, 15-11. And now that will really set up our second half of the year very well, as York and Ottawa have already played their home and home.
Yep.
And with that in the books now, both sport a 7-1 record. Eight and one. My correction. We want to thank you for joining us this afternoon here at Montpetit Hall for this very exciting match. Please join us tomorrow at 2 p.m. as Ottawa Gigi's host Nipissing here at home. An excellent match. On behalf of Catherine Weir, I'm Bill Swires. Thank you for joining us, and good night.